नाउ सी दिस प्रॉब्लम. फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डेथ ऑफ पार्टनर. ए बी एंड सी वेर पार्टनर्स इन ए फर्म शेयरिंग प्रॉफिट्स एंड लॉसेस इन द रेशो ऑफ 5:4:3. On 1st March 2015, their balance sheet was as under. Their balance sheet is given. After the balance sheet, they told us that A died on 1st October 2015 and B and C decided to share future profits in the ratio of 7:5. Remaining terms and conditions were given. First, in first adjustment, they told us to calculate the goodwill. Goodwill to be valued at 2.5 years purchase of average profit of last 4 years. In the second adjustment, they told us revaluation of assets. Now the adjustment C, that is third adjustment. Profit for the year 15-16 to be taken as having accrued at the same rate as that of the previous year. It means while calculating A's share of profit to be calculated on the basis of the profit of previous year. Then the adjustment D, interest on capital to be provided at 10% per annum. And in the last adjustment, they told us that half of the amount due to A to be paid immediately to the executor and remaining amount to be transferred to executor's loan account. So we have to prepare A's capital account and A's executor's account as on 1st October 2015. Okay, so let us start. In the problem, old ratio and new ratio is given. Just like retirement, we have to calculate gaining ratio. Calculation of gaining ratio. Old ratio is 5:4:3. That is 5/12, 4/12 and 3/12. New ratio between B and C after A's death, 7:5. That is 7/12 and 5/12. So let us calculate gaining ratio. Gaining ratio is equal to new ratio minus old ratio. Therefore, for partner B, B gains new ratio. B's new ratio is 7/12 minus old ratio is 4/12. So his gain will be 3/12. Now C gains new ratio 5/12 minus old ratio 3/12. Is equal to 2/12. Therefore, their gaining ratio will be is equal to 3:2, in which ratio we have to make adjustment of goodwill. Now we will calculate goodwill. So valuation of goodwill, see the adjustment. In the adjustment, they have given us 4 years profits and they told us that goodwill is valued at 2.5 years purchase of average profit of last 4 years. So let us start. First we have to calculate total profit. Total profit is equal to, see the profits given in the adjustment, 19,000 plus 15,000 plus 20,000 plus 18,000, so is equal to 72,000. Addition is 72,000. Now we have to calculate average profit. So average profit is equal to total profit divided by number of years. So is equal to 72,000 divided by 4, because 4 years. So is equal to 18,000. So average profit is rupees 18,000. Therefore now goodwill is equal to average profit into number of years purchase therefore 18,000 into 2.5 years purchase means 2.5 years purchase. So goodwill of the firm, it is goodwill of the firm, you can write here goodwill of the firm. So goodwill of the firm is 18,000 into 2.5, that is 45,000 goodwill of the firm. Now we have to calculate deceased partner's share of goodwill. So A's share of goodwill is equal to 45,000 into his share, that is 5/12, so is equal to 18,750. So A's share of goodwill is 18,750, and this goodwill amount is to be adjusted into capital accounts of B and C in their gaining ratio, that is 3:2. So the entry will be B's capital account debit, C's capital account debit to A's capital account. Okay. So I have passed entry of goodwill here. B's capital account debit 11,250, C's capital account debit 7,500 to A's capital account 18,750. Now we will calculate share of profit payable to A. They told us that profit will be calculated on the basis of previous year's profit, that is rupees 18,000. So we have assumed that 18,000 profit will be in this year per annum. So as the partner A is alive for 6 months, profit of the firm for 6 months, we have to calculate 18,000 into 6/12. So the answer will be rupees 9,000. Now 6 months profit of the firm was rupees 9,000, and from this profit the deceased partner, that is Mr. A, will get his share of profit. Therefore A's share of profit is equal to 9,000 into A's share, which was rupees 5/12. So the answer will be $3,750. So A's share of profit is $3,750, which will be credited to A. Okay. So we have completed all the working notes: calculation of gaining ratio, valuation of goodwill, and share of profit payable to A. So now we have to prepare revaluation account for calculating revaluation profit or loss, whatever it may be. Then they have asked us to prepare A's capital account and A's executor's account. Okay, so let us start. First we will prepare revaluation account. In the adjustment B, that is second adjustment, they told us the revaluation of assets. So let us enter the revalued amounts. Patents to be valued at rupees 8,000. Old value in the balance sheet was rupees 11,000. So in the new balance sheets, patents to be valued at rupees 8,000. There is reduction in the value of patents, so it is loss to the firm. So patents 3,000, that is difference between 11,000 and 8,000. Then machinery is valued at 28,000. Old amount of machinery is 30,000 and revalued amount is 28,000. So there is reduction of 2,000. So two machinery 2,000, and building at rupees 25,000. Old value of building is rupees 20,000 and new value is 25,000. So there is appreciation. So by buildings there is appreciation of 5,000. So by building 5,000. Okay, now let us tally the revaluation account. credit total is 5000 and debit total is 5000, so there is no revaluation profit or loss in this problem. So there is neither profit nor loss due to revaluation of assets in this problem. Now let us prepare A's capital account. First we have to credit by A's capital balance. So by balance brought down, see the balance sheet. A's capital is given rupees 30,000, so 30,000. Now we have to credit by the general reserve given in the problem. General reserve means reserve is given rupees 6,000. So by reserve, rupees 6,000 into A's share, that is 5/12. So his share will be rupees 2,500. Then we will make entry of goodwill. We have passed entry here. B's capital account debit, C's capital account debit to A's capital account. So by B's capital account and by C's capital account, amounts are 11,250 and 7,500. Okay, this is the entry of goodwill, posting of entry of goodwill. Now we have calculated share, his share of profit 3750. So let us calculate share of profit by profit and loss suspense account. We have calculated the amount 3750. Now in the second last adjustment, interest on capital to be provided at 10% per annum. His capital is 30,000, 10% will be 3,000 per annum, and for 6 months it will be rupees 1,500. So by interest on capital, rupees 1,500. Now see the balance sheet. In asset side, advertisement suspense account is given, so we have to transfer A's share to advertisement suspense account. A's share in total rupees 12,000 will be rupees 5,000, that is 12,000 into 5/12, so 5,000. Now let us tally A's capital account. We will make total of this side. Total is 56,500. We'll deduct rupees 5,000 from it. The balance will be 51,500. This balance will be transferred to A's executor's account. Now we will prepare A's executor's account. Second posting of this entry, by A's capital account, rupees 51,500. And now see the last adjustment. They told us that half of the amount due to A is to be paid immediately to the executor. So from this amount we will give him half amount, and remaining amount will be transferred to his loan account. So to bank account, half of 51,500 will be 25,750. So 25,750 will be paid him immediately, that is to his executor, and remaining amount will be transferred to executor's loan account. So A's executor's loan account, we will transfer remaining amount to his loan account. And so debit total is will be 51,500 and 51,500. This account is tallied. ओके दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे.